small town nestled in the hills of northwest Pennsylvania alongside the Allegheny River. From the beginning, the town of Tidewood was connected to the cutlery industry. Groups of cutlery workers who had emigrated from Sheffield, England, migrated from factories in New England to the vicinity of Tidewood and northern Pennsylvania to establish their own businesses. During America's golden age of cutlery in the 1890s to the 1930s, there were a number of companies and spin-offs that offered quality knives produced in Tidewood. Names like Tidewood Cutlery, Union Razor, Union Cutlery, Baldwin Cutlery or Penn Cutlery are long gone. Today these names are only familiar to knife collectors. K-Bar is a very famous knife company today, but only a few know that the first company to manufacture a knife trademarked K-Bar was founded in 1897 as the Tidewood Cutlery Company. In fact, there were even two cutlery companies with the name Tidewood, but both ceased to exist in the early 1900s. 100 years later, in 2006, master knife makers Bill Howard and Ken Daniels founded the Great Eastern Cutlery Company. Great Eastern Cutlery, very often abbreviated to GEC, is located in Titusville, Pennsylvania, about 20 miles west of Tidewood. And thanks to GEC, the old Tidewood Cutlery brand is alive again. They also revived another brand of the good old days, the Northfield Unexcelled brand, of which I already reviewed a knife, this Northfield Unexcelled jackknife. By the way, all GEC knives come with these unique cardboard storage tubes. I got both knives from Northwest Knife Company, an online store that is run by Gary Norton. He is a great guy to do business with. He has always been very helpful and responsive to my questions. His online store offers a great range of both GEC brands, Tidewood and Northfield Unexcelled, and I can highly recommend his business. Now for today's knife, the Tidewood Weaver Jack, with the item number 563311. For those of you who are not familiar with traditional American knife patterns, let me just briefly explain the term jackknife. Jackknife is a general term for the simplest form of folding knife. The standard jackknife is single-ended, which means that its blade is hinged at one end of the handle. But over the decades, the cutlery companies came up with endless variations of this knife pattern. There are not only single-end but also double-end jackknives, and there are all kinds of blade shapes and combinations of blades. There are several criteria for classifying jackknives. For simplicity reasons, we concentrate on only one important aspect, the handle shape. As you can see, this handle is slightly curved. There are several names for jackknives with a curved handle like this. Very often they are called serpentine jacks, but this curvature in particular is also referred to as dogleg. Why dogleg? Let's take a look. GEC calls this pattern reverse dogleg. I guess it has to do with the orientation of the curvature. Before we examine this knife any further, let's take a closer look at the item number 563311. It is stamped on the back of the main blade's tang and is actually composed of four individual numbers. You can look up the meaning of these numbers on the GEC website. The first two digits, the 56, is the actual pattern number. 56 denotes the reverse dogleg pattern. The next number, 3, denotes the shape of the main blade. In our case, it's a sheepfoot blade. The third number, again the number 3, tells us the number of blades. And the last two digits stand for the year of manufacture, 2011. The knife is 3.5 inches long when closed, and the weight comes in at 100 grams. The handle material is rather unusual for a traditional pocket knife. They usually come with bone or stack handles. This material is micarta and has this nice combination of brown and beige colors. GEC calls this color rust red, and it's simply beautiful. The micarta slabs are nicely contoured, and they are mounted with 4 brass pins. The T-Diode inlay shield is also attached with a pin. As far as I know, GEC doesn't use glue at all on these beauties. The shield and the 2 bolsters are made of nickel silver. As for the blades, this particular Weaver Jack model comes with 3 blades. It's also available with 1 blade. All 3 blades come with a nail nick here on the front of the main blade and on the back of the other 2 blades. Great Eastern Cutlery uses a blade steel that was already used by T-Diode Cutlery in the early 1900s, 1095 carbon steel. 1095 carbon steel is reasonably tough, holds an edge well, and is easy to sharpen to a razor edge. The only downside is that it will rust if not taken care of. A quick wipe down after use and a drop of oil now and then will keep it in good condition though. The main blade is a sheepfoot blade and is decorated with this laser etching, the old T-Diode Cutlery trademark. The stamp on the front of the tank says T-Diode Cutlery, made in USA, and as I already mentioned, the pattern number is on the back of the tank. Now, the main characteristic feature of a sheepfoot blade is this rounded tip. But usually, a sheepfoot blade comes with a straight cutting edge. However, this edge is slightly curved inwards. In a way, the blade shape resembles a hawkbill blade. Of course, the curvature is not as pronounced as the hook shape of a karambit knife, for example, but instead of calling it a sheepfoot blade, you could also call it a modified hawkbill blade. I haven't been able to find out why this knife is marketed under the name Weaver Jack, but maybe it's because of this particular blade shape. This hawkbill-like blade shape is good for cutting textiles and rope, and maybe in the old days, this knife was especially popular in or marketed towards the textile industry. But that's just my speculation. The second blade is a classic clip-point blade with a swatch and an acute tip. For everyday use, this blade is probably the most useful one because it can handle all kinds of cutting tasks. There is also a stamp on the tang. Great Eastern Cutlery, Titusville, Pennsylvania. And finally, the third blade is a small pen blade. The pen blade tang carries the Great Eastern Cutlery TIW stamping. All 3 blades operate on individual back springs that are separated by brass liners. Like all traditional American pocket knives, this T-Diode Weaver Jack is a slip joint knife. There is no locking mechanism. The springs are extremely well adjusted. You can open the blades easily, and at the same time, the springs are sufficiently tight to hold the blades in place when they are open. By the way, the main blade comes with an additional safety feature. It stops halfway. The overall fit and finish of this knife is outstanding. All 3 blades are perfectly centered. There are no gaps. Everything is flush. This knife is absolutely flawless. The craftsmanship and quality are awesome. And that's what Great Eastern Cutlery knives have become famous for. The Weaver Jack is definitely made for everyday use, and I've already carried it as my EDC knife. But I absolutely understand people who put a knife like this in a display cabinet and only take it out from time to time to enjoy the look of it. In any case, it's a knife that can be passed down from generation to generation with pride, but you should also pass on a bit of the history behind it, because this knife can take you on a journey into America's golden age of cutlery. Although this knife was made in 2011, it's a piece of history in the palm of your hand. Thanks for watching.